extremely proud of the progress we have made throughout 2016-17. We completed our biggest ever community challenge programme, having a huge impact on 8 local projects, including schools, churches and community halls. Schoolyards were transformed, churches and community halls treated to new kitchens, and gallons of paint used to spruce up local facilities. The partnership programme involved 12 of our main contractors and suppliers, who as part of their contracts with us commit to giving something back to the community. They provided their skills and expertise in undertaking the projects and were joined by over 20 of our employees who volunteered their time. In total, over 350 hours were spent working on the different projects.
The kitchen here badly needed refurbishing in order to help the life of the church here, but also the community groups that use the place. So we're very happy with what's been done for us.
Our WHQS programme came to a conclusion. The work saw upgrades to our properties with over 7,400 new kitchens, 6,910 new bathrooms, 4,535 rewires and 5,499 new heating systems being fitted. We also carried out over 2,200 roof replacements, 5,400 window and door installations, and we've completed over 3,000 external wall installations and renders. 30,000 bees took up residency at our head office as part of a wider health and wellbeing strategy which will benefit the local community. The initiative will see local primary schools take an active part in the project and will benefit from educational talks about bees and the chance to enhance their habitat by making bug houses, with support from our apprentices. We signed up to become a dementia-friendly organisation, with several staff becoming dementia friends in order to give them an understanding of the personal impact of dementia and what they can do to help.
We've introduced the course because we want staff to be able to identify the signs and symptoms of people they're helping who may be suffering from dementia, and so they'll be better able to help tenants and also help friends or family that may be suffering from the condition as well.
We took on an additional 5 multi-trade apprentices. When qualified, the 5 will be equipped to enjoy a varied and engaging work environment, carrying out a wide range of repair and maintenance work in both occupied and empty properties. 2 of our apprentices, Lindsay Davis and Rory Diplock, were shortlisted for CHC's Welsh Apprentice Challenge, with Lindsay being on the winning team. We offered Mid and West Wales Fire and Rescue Service a unique training environment at our disused Catchev residential complex in Skewin. Prior to its demolition, the fire service used the buildings for training purposes, using synthetic smoke and a carefully controlled fire to stimulate the conditions they encounter when tackling house fires. A new outdoor learning space and community garden was opened at St Joseph's School in Patalbert, thanks to a £5,000 grant from our Community Development Fund. The Welsh Government gave us their seal of approval when they assessed us as having a standard rating, the highest level possible. We scooped silverware in the Regional Housing Association category at the Energy Efficiency and Healthy Homes Award ceremony. This recognised our WHQS programme and the additional benefits this has given our tenants. A prestigious list of the top UK landlords saw us come in at number 28. Judges were impressed with the progress we have made to enhance our properties and the support which has seen us secure millions in unclaimed benefits for our tenants. Nadine Satchi, Carla Thomas and Kirsty Jeffries were all recognised by 24 Housing magazine in a UK-wide search to find the brightest young talent that will be the housing leaders in the future. Nadine stood out for being hugely compassionate, while judges were equally impressed with Carla's innovative ideas and Kirsty's desire to build relationships and improve working practices. We marked our Safety Week with a series of roadshows in Patalbert, Pontardawe and Neath, raising awareness of the importance of getting heating systems checked and serviced. It obviously has an effect, as just weeks later we achieved a 100% compliance rate for the servicing of our boilers. We made 118 promises to our tenants upon transfer. So far, we have fulfilled 111 of them and are on course to complete the remaining 7. We've had a significant economic impact, with £1.99 being invested into the local economy for every £1 we've spent. Our financial inclusion team and universal credit teams have made almost 2,000 home visits and held 675 surgery appointments between them. This has helped secure an additional £3.5 million in benefits and payments for our tenants. We recognise that sometimes things may go wrong and we want to ensure that we put things right as quickly as possible. 90% of the complaints we receive are resolved quickly and usually at the time the customer contacts us first. In the last year we carried out over 31,000 repairs on our properties, of which 6,872 was classed as emergencies, 7,150 urgent and 17,073 as non-urgent. 90% of our customers felt their repairs were completed right the first time, and 94% felt their repair was completed within a reasonable time. According to our surveys, 90% of tenants would recommend us to their family and friends. The same percentage of people are happy with the quality of their home, with 89% being happy with their neighbourhood. 84% believe that the rent they pay provides value for money. 80% of our customers trust us, with 79% saying that we provide the service they expect. Overall, 88% of our tenants are happy with what we do. We have over 500 employees, of which 75% of them live locally. Our voluntary turnover is 4.85%. We are passionate about developing our employees and invested £219,000 in the last year on training and development. They spent an equivalent of 393.5 days on learning and 1,072 days on training. We have produced an annual review document called Achieving Success, which you can find on our new website www.titarian.co.uk.